Conviction in our hearts, crying out to the heavens on the plains of Arafat, standing proud beside my brother, silent at Muzdalifa.
Alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalam ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in, amma ba'd. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, we have been learning a lot of deeds, a lot of acts that which can be preferably done during these 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah. In the previous episodes, we learnt about the act of worship, which is a Zikr. And that is one of the most virtuous acts to be done during these first 10 days. Today, inshallah, we will continue speaking on the same topic of making dhikr of Allah with our beloved Sheikh Haitham al Haddad from UK. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Sheikh, alhamdulillah, we had learnt in detail about the way how the zikr needs to be done and what are its virtues and how was the attitude of our salaf. So what more, or could you add more details to this virtuous act of zikr during these first 10 days?
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salam ala Rasulillah. Obviously, when we talk about dhikr, we need maybe a full series to talk about dhikr. The topic of dhikr is so vast. We just mentioned a few ahadith about the importance of dhikr. We mentioned a very important hadith which highlights the nature of dhikr that we want, that Allah Jalla wa Ala wants from us.
That's right.
We mentioned hadith Abu Darda radiallahu ta'ala anhu, in which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us that dhikr is more virtuous than jihad fi sabilillah.
Subhanallah.
Which is dhikr? What is that dhikr that is more virtuous than jihad? We said that dhikr in which the tongue synchronizes with the heart. So in reality, it is the dhikr of the heart. And the tongue is expressing this, which means that the person is mindful of Allah Jalla wa Ala all the time. And when the person is mindful of Allah Jalla wa Ala all the time, he is remembering Allah Jalla wa Ala all the time. Then, as Ibn Hajar said, when the person remembers anything that pleases Allah Jalla wa Ala, he will be the first one to do it. When something happens which needs him to be involved in it for the sake of Allah Jalla wa Ala, he will be the first person to be involved in that. So he said, because this person is mindful of Allah Jalla wa Ala, when the time of jihad comes, he will be the first person to go for jihad. So what motivated him to go for jihad is
the zikr of Allah.
The zikr, the real zikr.
The real zikr of Allah.
Of Allah Jalla wa Ala, which is in his heart. When the time to give sadaqah comes, he doesn't think 10 times before giving £1 or $1. No, because Allah Jalla wa Ala is present in his life. He sees Allah Jalla wa Ala all the time. He is mindful of Allah Jalla wa Ala all the time. So he will be the first one to give sadaqah.
He reaches that level of ihsan.
Jazakallah khair, wallahi, brother Kaleem. I testify by Allah in front of you, ya brothers, that I did not mention this point to brother Kaleem. He just picked it up. That was on my tongue.
MashaAllah.
The issue of ihsan. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam defined ihsan as what? أن تعبد الله كأنك ترى. In Hadith Umar, all of us know, when the angel Jibreel asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about the definition of Islam, about the definition of Iman, and about ihsan.
About ihsan.
What is ihsan? He said, الإحسان أن تعبد الله كأنك ترى. You worship Allah كأنك, as you see Allah Jalla wa Ala. If you don't see Allah Jalla wa Ala, then Allah Jalla wa Ala sees you.
Sees us.
So, when we say that we are mindful of Allah Jalla wa Ala all the time, and some scholars even uses the word, and they said this is the word of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, you worship Allah as you see him. So you see Allah Jalla wa Ala everywhere. You see Allah Jalla wa Ala everywhere means that you are remembering Allah Jalla wa Ala everywhere.
Not the physical seeing of Allah Subhanahu, because obviously. No eye can see Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala.
Obviously, especially in the dunya.
In this dunya.
So when the person is mindful of Allah Jalla wa Ala, all the time, as the Prophet said to Ibn Abbas, احفظِ اللَّهَ يَحْفَظُ. Be mindful of Allah Jalla wa Ala, He will be mindful of you. احفظِ اللَّهَ, what does it mean? Remember, memorize Allah? No. Be mindful of Allah Jalla wa Ala. But how to be mindful of Allah Jalla wa Ala? To remember Him all the time, so you abstain from what He doesn't like, and to go for what He likes.
MashaAllah.
All the time. So this is the kind of dhikr, my dear brothers and sisters, that we want. I know Peace TV, mashallah, has been watched by thousands or millions of people from different parts of the world. Some people think that dhikr of Allah Jalla wa Ala is to sit in a gathering and La ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah. Or maybe sometimes they have singing, even it doesn't include La ilaha illallah.
Allah.
It might not include La ilaha illallah. It might not include Subhanallah. I remember I was in Sudan and there was an occasion, I don't know what it was, Rajab or something like this. So a group of people came in the courtyard of the masjid. I remember that masjid in Khartoum. And between Maghrib and Isha, they came a little bit late after Maghrib, they started to do singing and dancing. They're dancing with sticks in the masjid. And then the Adhan came. They continued doing dancing and singing because it is, overwhelming and it is nice. Then I said to one of them, Ya Sheikh, now the Salah, we want to pray. He said, this is dhikr. This is dhikr. I said, I did not hear La ilaha illallah or Muhammad Rasulullah. Maybe one time they say, Ya Habib Allah Muhammad. They are talking, but this is not the dhikr. If you mention the word Muhammad, it doesn't mean that you are saying Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Yeah, you will be rewarded not when you say Ya Habib Allah Muhammad. That's when you say Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. You will not be when you say the word Allah alone.
That's right.
What do you mean by Allah alone? You should say the dhikr that we learned and the Prophet ﷺ taught us is to say La ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah. Lahul mulk wa lahul hamd wa huwa ala kulli shayin qadir. Or Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar, La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. So when we talk about dhikr, we should go and see how the Prophet ﷺ taught us to do dhikr.
So even the words should be the same.
Even the words should be the same. Some adhkar, changing the word is not acceptable.
Definitely.
You know, when the Prophet ﷺ was teaching Al-Bara ibn Azib the dua before going to bed. He taught him
Nabi to Rasul.
قال وَأَمَنْتُ بِنَبِيِّكَ الَّذِي أَرْسَلْتِ. Then he said, وَأَمَنْتُ بِرَسُولِكَ الَّذِي أَرْسَلْتِ. I believed in your Rasul. He said, no. I taught you to say وَنَبِيِّكَ الَّذِي.
Definitely.
Yeah, and I believed in your Nabi. So some dhikr, not all, some dhikr you have to follow strictly what has been said. And part of the dhikr is heavily regulated. Half of the dhikr is not heavily regulated. It is regulated in general.
In general.
So what we advise people to do is to stick to the sunnah in dhikr. And the second point is to have targets in dhikr.
MashaAllah.
Targets. For example, when the person should plan for the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, what is he going to achieve? You know, we plan for everything. We plan for our holidays. But the last thing we plan for it is our Jannah.
Unfortunately.
Our Akhirah. Our Ibadah. When we wake up in the morning, we think of what we want to achieve this day. We rarely think that, okay, where I'm going to pray Dhuhr. And when I pray Dhuhr, I need to make sure that I'll pray 4 rak'ah before Dhuhr, so I should not delay the Dhuhr in a way that I will rush to the Salah, then I will lose the 4 rak'ah before Dhuhr. The Prophet ﷺ said 4 rak'ah before Dhuhr is equal to Salat al-Sahar, is equal like praying at the middle of the night or the third part of the night. This is part of the planning. Similarly, when the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah are starting, many people are, I traveled to some countries, I had to travel to some countries during the 10 days or before the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, and people were unaware. Some people were unaware the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah were coming.
Inshallah, after this series, inshallah, everyone will start in worshipping Allah as much as possible during these first 10 days, inshallah.
Part of it is to be aware when are they going to come. Those people, sometimes the people who are going for Hajj, they will be aware of it because of Hajj, etc. And they have to know the timing and the booking and the other logistics. But the other people,
totally unaware.
They are unaware. Why? Because they are not planning for them. Why? Because they don't know the importance of those 10 days. Subhanallah. Each second, as you mentioned in one of the previous episodes, is so precious. Saying Subhanallah, if we take what Anas ibn Malik said, that working in one day is equal to working in 1,000 days, saying Subhanallah one time during these days, as if you have said Subhanallah 1,000 times in any other day.
MashaAllah.
So that's why I recommend people to have targets.
Sure.
So, for example, the person might say, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the one who says, La ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lahu lahu al-mulk wa lahu al-hamdu wa huwa ala kulli shayin qadir, it will be equal as if he freed 10 slaves from Bani Ismail. Yeah? Saying, La ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lahu lahu al-mulk wa lahu al-hamdu wa huwa ala kulli shayin qadir 100 times in your day. So this is one of the most frequent dhikr that should be there. Every single one of us should.
Whether the days of Zulhijjah or the other days
or
as well.
Or other days. But in particular, in days of Zulhijjah, make more of this. And hundreds. So the person can say, I want to plan to have 5,000 La ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lahu lahul mulk wa lahul hamdu wa huwa ala kulli shayin qadir. Because when Sharia said 100, it means as if the Sharia is allowing us to have targets.
MashaAllah.
In terms of the dhikr.
Jazakallahu khairan, Shaykh. Inshallah, we will continue speaking more on this, but after a short break.
Crying out to the heavens on the plains of Arafat.
Labbaik Allahumma labbaik.
Labbaik Allahumma labbaik.
Labbaik la sharika laka
labbaik. La sharika laka labbaik.
Innal hamda.
Innal hamda.
Wa ni'mata.
Wa ni'mata.
Laka wal mulk.
Laka wal mulk.
La sharika laka.
Today, one of the most common misconceptions in the world about Islam is that Islam was fed by the sword. But the noted historian, the late O'Leary, has a different opinion in his book, Islam at the Crossroads, on page number 8. He says that history makes it clear, however, that the legend of fanatical Muslims sweeping through the world and forcing Islam at the point of the sword upon conquered races is one of the most fantastically absurd myths that the historians have ever repeated.
Most countries of the world ban bullying. They fight it in their schools and universities. A lot of us are being bullied differently every single day. Some come up to us and say, do this, while others say, don't you dare. Some say this is halal, while others say, nope, this is haram. Are you confused? Do you feel lost? Join me in Umdat al-Ahkam, where, with the grace of Allah, we will learn the proper knowledge from the Quran and from the Sunnah, which would help stop this kind of bullying.
Join Asim al-Hakim in Umdat al-Ahkam, next on Peace TV.
Crying out to the heavens on the plains of Arafat.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back after the break. Sheikh, we were talking about the target setting for the zikr of Allah in the first 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah.
So this is one. La ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lahu lahu al-mulk wa lahu al-hamd wa huwa ala kulli shayin qadir. Another important dhikr is the tasbih. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once was sitting with his companions. And he said to them, is it difficult for one of you to earn 1,000 hasana every day? They said, how, Ya Rasulullah? He said, if you say, Subhanallah wa bihamdihi, Not even subhanallah bihamdi, subhanallah al-azim. No, subhanallah bihamdi.
Just the subhanallah wa bihamdi.
100 times, Allah Jalla wa Ala will give you 1,000 hasana.
MashaAllah.
Akhi, sometimes in the queue, if you are queuing for a bus or to buy something or post office, this is in the countries that they queue.
Especially in India as well.
Yeah, some countries they don't have a queue. They just fight in order to buy something. Okay, inshallah. We say that all of us are civilized, so we queue. Sometimes in the queue, you might stay 3 minutes, 4 minutes, 5 minutes. I ask all of our audience, if you were to say subhanallah bihamdi, subhanallah bihamdi, quickly, subhanallah bihamdi, subhanallah bihamdi, subhanallah bihamdi, subhanallah bihamdi, you will be able to finish 100 times in 2 minutes or in 2.5 minutes.
Inshallah.
Try it, maybe I'm not.
And synchronize that zikr with your heart.
With your heart. Even, by the way, once we say synchronize it with your heart, it doesn't mean that if you cannot synchronize it by your heart, you are not going to be rewarded for it. No.
Inshallah, the reward remains, alhamdulillah.
Different level of reward, but you will be rewarded.
Inshallah.
Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala said that Allah Jalla wa'ala created angels and they are building houses for those who are making dhikr. So if you are making dhikr, the angels are building houses, you know, big buildings for you.
Mansions in Jannah.
Mansions in Jannah. When you stop dhikr, they stop.
Allahu Akbar.
The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he, wallahi, this is very amazing. Please, brothers, look at this, look at this. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ascended in Al-Mi'raj, he met Adam, Musa, Yusuf, Idris alayhi salam. And in the highest heaven, in the seventh heaven,
he found Ibrahim.
He met Ibrahim alayhi salam.
So
Ibrahim alayhi salam, the most beloved prophet to Allah Jalla wa Ala, that's why he was in the seventh heaven after Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The second most beloved prophet to Allah Jalla wa Ala after Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is Ibrahim, Khalilur Rahman. He said, Ya Muhammad, like this is a very touching hadith. Ya Muhammad, tell your ummah salam, pass my salam to your ummah. Ya Allah. Pass my salam to your ummah. And tell them that Al-Jannah is very sweet, very nice, very tayyiba. This is the advice. Ibrahim is worried about Jannah. He's not worried about the victory of Muslims. He's not worried about the social affairs of Muslims. He is not worried about the reform of Islam. He's not worried about these things. He's worried about what?
Jannah.
Jannah. Pass my salam to your ummah and tell them that the Jannah is tayyiba, very sweet. Yeah? The highest level of pleasure in Jannah. Wa anna ghirasaha means it is planted by. It is planted by means the Jannah, in order to get it, to have it, to have a place, to secure a place in it. Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wallahu akbar, wa la ilaha illallah. I don't remember exactly what he said and which narration.
The same,
but this is an authentic
Allahu
narration.
MashaAllah.
Subhanallah, look. On the seventh heaven, the most important meeting in the world. I wrote an article about it on Islam21c.com. It was not, I don't know, by now, maybe Tuesday. Will be published. The most important meeting in dunya, the most important meeting by who? By the two most important people. Who are the most important two people in this life?
Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Ibrahim.
Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Ibrahim. No one is more important than Muhammad or Ibrahim. May Allah send his salam upon them. Sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. Wasallam. What is the main discussion regarding, what was the main topic of their meeting? The main topic of their meeting, subhanallah, is the most important thing in our life. What is the most important thing in our life? Is Jannah, our akhirah. What is the most important thing in this dunya and in the akhirah, in Jannah? Is Allah.
Allah subhanahu.
So it is the most important meeting between the most important people in the highest place that people can ever meet in, which is the seventh heaven. And what is the most important topic? And it is concerning what? It is concerning Jannah. And what is the topic? How to go there? By dhikr of Allah.
Allahu Akbar. It's an amazing hadith. Alhamdulillah.
We can talk a lot about
inshallah
dhikr of Allah. As the scholar said, Allah Jalla wa Ala says, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu dhkurullaha dhikran kathira. They said that when Allah Jalla wa Ala commands us, Ya waqimu salawatu zaka. But dhikr, he said kathir.
Kathir.
Abundantly. A lot. وَالذَّاكِرِينَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا وَالذَّاكِرَاتِ
The word كَثِيرًا is there associated with
yes,
dhikr.
Yes, with dhikr. On the other ayah, إِنَّ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافِ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ لَآيَاتٍ لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ Signs for those who think. Who are those? الَّذِينَ يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ He didn't say كَثِير here, but he said what? قِيَامًا وَقُعُودًا وَعَلَى جُنُوبِهِمْ وَيَتَفَكَّرُونَ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ
Which is dhikr?
كَثِير
MashaAllah.
Qiyam, Qu'ud, yes, and on their sides. This is dhikr of Allah Jalla wa Ala. Now, many people, when they hear, you know, kalimatani khafifatani ala lisan, everyone knows this hadith.
Yes, the last hadith of anyone, Bukhari.
Yeah, last hadith in Sahih Bukhari, you will find it everywhere written. I doubt that many of us don't know about this hadith. Yeah, yet, do we do it frequently? In many cases, you find people, wallahi, yani I use public transportation in London. Here, I used it once, okay? Although Peace TV was looking after me and they did not allow me to use public transportation. But I want to use public transportation to see people. You find people just sitting in the train, in the public transportation. If you ask them, do you know the hadith? كَلِمَتَانِ خَفِيفَتَانِ عَلَى اللِّسَانِ ثَقِيلَتَانِ فِي الْمِيزَانِ
They would say yes.
Yes. Why don't you do it? Because, my dear brothers and sisters, listen to this. Allah is not here. If Allah is here, Allah will be everywhere in your life. You will see Allah everywhere. You will be mindful of Allah Jalla wa Ala all the time. So you will make dhikr of Allah Jalla wa Ala as a result of this. Our Sheikh Ibn Baz, I attended Sheikh Ibn Baz, rahimahullah ta'ala, in many places. We hardly remember, I don't remember that I have ever seen his lips closed.
Allahu Akbar.
Dhikr of Allah Jalla wa Ala. Even it seems that dhikr of Allah Jalla wa Ala became yani, on his tongue subconsciously. Yeah, he answers the phone sometimes when he waits for the caller. He makes Subhanallah, La ilaha, Allahu Akbar. Unless he wants to focus really. And I remember Yani sharing the food with him, he was a very generous person. Whenever we used to go to him, if he is free, he would say, come, join us for Asha, Ghada.
Have Allah some mercy food. On him.
Ameen, Rahimahullah. He used to eat. He used to take it, chew the food, chew each morsel. And then, while he was chewing, it happened many times. I saw it. I did not hear it from anyone. I saw it, I heard it myself, that he would thank Allah Jalla wa Ala as if he was so hungry, as if he was suffering from famine, as if he did not find food, and this is the first time for him to find food. Alhamdulillah, 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 alhamdulillah. If you were to hear, you would say, oh, subhanallah, this person did not find food, and this is the first time he finds food. Because once Allah Jalla wa Ala is present in our life, then Allah Jalla wa Ala will be present, or His remembrance will be present on our tongues.
Inshallah.
Maybe this is enough about dhikr. But what I want to say is that if we take this period, the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, as a period where we increase our dhikr of Allah Jalla wa Ala, our remembrance of Allah Jalla wa Ala, then it is likely that the dhikr of Allah Jalla wa Ala will remain with us more than the 10 days of the Hijjah, and we will get used to this habit.
Jazakallahu khairan, Shaykh. MashaAllah, there were some very amazing ahadith that which we came across today in this episode about making the dhikr of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. And the ulama of the present day age, we are not talking about the sahaba, the first three generations, we're talking about the present day ulama, Shaykh Ibn Baz rahimahullah, Shaykh Muhammad bin Salih al-Uthaymeen, and their likes, alhamdulillah, they kept their tongues busy even while eating the food. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala help me and you and all of viewers on Peace TV to continue to make zikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as often as possible, for this is one of the greatest acts of worship that which a person can do. Inshallah, we will continue speaking more on this topic of the virtues of the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, but in the coming episodes. Until then, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
All across ocean and land, incumbent on all men, is the pilgrimage to Mecca, fifth pillar of Islam. In the footsteps of Muhammad, the last prophet of